The Ghana Police Service has issued a statement in relation to the shooting incident that occurred yesterday at the Babayaro Stadium involving one of their men. Now, the major takeaway from the statement, though, is that a police officer who fired the shot has been interdicted on the instruction of the regional minister pending investigation. Now, the police in the statement also said they view the issue as a serious matter and will give it the level of seriousness it deserves. Investigations have already begun and the force says they need a collaborative effort from the public to get the culprits of the barbaric acts at the stadium and bring them to book. Well, let's check out what's happening in Kumasi at the moment. And my colleague Evans Inkum is at the regional police headquarters there in Kumasi and has filed this report.
Operator, the victim in the shooting incident is not out of wounds yet, but information we are getting from the Konfanochi Teaching Hospital is that he is responding to simple commands, an improvement of what the situation was yesterday. But the police has also been busy as far as this particular development is concerned. They have been responding to media barrage of questions, trying to know between two things as to whether what happened yesterday as per the shooting was on professional lines or a breach of ethics. The police for now will not take responsibility, only to say that investigation has been commenced to know what really happened and in the future produce some evidence to buttress their stance as far as this particular incident is concerned. But let me tell you what they have been saying as per the responsibility that I spoke earlier. So in the paragraph 2 of their statement, the police said the incident occurred when supporters of Kumasi Asante Kotoko FC went on rampage after their league match against Brekum Chelsea FC at the stadium, damaging some police vehicles and injuring some police officers with stones that were pelted at the police. So the assumption is that this might have triggered the police action. The policeman in question has been interdicted pending investigation into the matter. We will continue to give you update as and when they unfold. For TV3 News, William Evans Inkum, Kumasi.
Well, that's William Evans Inkum there. Now, still on this issue, let's go on the phone and speak to George Ampemdakun, who was the former the vice chairman of the GFA Security Committee during Mr. Nyantechi's regime. And thank you very much for joining us, sir. And this is Midday Live on TV3.
Thank you, Victor.
Well, now, the new administration at the FA stressed on a zero tolerance for violence policy. Now, yesterday, there was an incident of violence at one of the major centers, and that's Kumasi. Now, why has it become so difficult to deal with this menace?
Well. Thank you very much for having me on the show. It is becoming very difficult because we are not doing what is right. We are not doing what is right. And we are not giving the education. So, for now, that is what I can say.
Right. Mr. Pimdako, now, how can the FA handle a situation like this?
Yeah, you know, even when you go to FIFA has directed every football association to have a safety and security committee. This committee, their prime aim is to always liaise with the security agencies so that whatever is going on within the association concerning league matches, venues, and everything, this committee will be the supervisory committee, and they will give the information to the security agencies and also to the FA so that they will know what to do. For example, if they are going to play any match, then let me take yesterday's match, for example, Kotoko against Brekum Chelsea. If there is any match of this nature coming on, the safety and security committee, first of all, will look at the performance of the teams in recent times. They will look at the history behind the teams whenever they meet, encounters between them. Then they will look at the behavior of their supporters and the behavior of their authorities. And for that matter, if you look at yesterday's game, for the last 6 years, Bokum Chelsea have been worrying Asante Kotoko at the Kumasi Sports Stadium. They didn't beat them. And so when you're going to play such a match, and we just have the recent past where Kotoko went to Bokum, played a league normalization committee match where there were down shots. So if you are a member of the security committee, you advise the AFA based on this historical antecedent. And so they will bring the security agencies who are going to their field so that the security agencies will be abreast with whatever involvement is there between the two teams. Because here in Ghana, we don't have police personnel that have been trained for stadium duties. If you go to England, we have these police officers who are for stadium duties. And so here we pick the police from different areas to go to the stadium and perform their duty. And so most of them, we don't know the history and everything behind the teams.
Right.
And therefore, the FA will have to get a committee that will supervise and advise about security arrangements of our league venues and how the police should go about their duties.
Right. Now, Mr. Apendako, a final one. I mean, the police have already begun investigations. The officer who fired the shot has also been interdicted. Is that the right way to go?
Well, as I said, the police, they will do their investigation. They've been interdicted the officer. But as I said, if you don't do vigorous education, for fans to know that matches are to be played, win, draw, or lose. If you don't do that, and this one too, it is for the club officials to take it upon themselves for the education, because they are spending their money. So if you spend your money and you always allow and tolerate such occurrences, it will affect the club and it will affect your finances that you get.
Right. Thank you very much, Mr. Apendako. Well, you heard that from George Apendako, who was the vice chairperson of the security committee at the Ghana Football Association under Mr. Nyantichi's era.